What up, YouTube? Topaz Jace back for another album review, and this one is to that Lute West 1996 Part 2. And for those of you who don't know who he is, he signed to Dreamsville with J. Cole and all that. And when I went through and did my research on him, didn't realize that he's from Charlotte, in which I'm from Charlotte, so I was like, I got to know who this individual is, you dig? But honestly, it makes sense that I don't, because he's from the west side, I'm from the north side, and even though Charlotte isn't that big of a city, it's not like New York where each borough is like their own cities and all of that is so far stretched out. Nah, but people within Charlotte, you tend to stick to your side until you go uptown into the center city, you did? So it kind of makes sense that I don't know of him like that, man, even though I do know a bunch of people from the west side, but there's more stuff that goes into why I really don't know him, or I may have heard of him before and completely forgot about him, but honestly, we're going to touch on that a little bit later. But this project is rather interesting because it's a concept project, and we don't get very many concept projects out here these days, man, where the basic concept on this is a bunch of stories of everything leading up to him getting signed to Dreamsville and all of that, man, which he's giving us a lot of detail into his lifestyle and how he was thinking at the time as he was coming up. And what's interesting is that he signed to Dreamsville, because when you look at Charlotte and look at North Carolina, it's a lot like all the other states that I've been to and all of that, man. Like, individual cities are influenced by others that are like hip-hop cities. And what's interesting about J. Cole selecting somebody from Charlotte, Charlotte is not really influenced by the same music that J. Cole is out there trying to get, you dig? Like, when you look at all of the artists that he's went out and signed, they all got that common theme to them, like that quote-unquote real hip-hop, that somewhat northern New York type feel to it, but yet still southern at the same time and all of that. Like, that doesn't fit what Charlotte does. Charlotte is more influenced by, say, Atlanta and Florida and all of that, you dig? While other cities within the state, from Raleigh to Fayetteville, where J. Cole's from, they're more influenced by New York. And that's how J. Cole honestly got his sound on where he's at and such right now. So it's rather unique that he found an artist within Charlotte that's doing somewhat close to what he wants. Well, if I were to break down Lute's sound, it more comes off as South, but yet it's like a cleaner South, not the dirty South that people tend to recognize the South for. So he's doing cleaner South that honestly gets recognized in the quote-unquote real hip-hop realm, so it makes a lot of sense, but yet it's kind of weird that he's here. But given the concept of this project, man, it makes a whole lot of sense that you can just ride completely out on this. Like, there's no one particular song that you could point out and say, that was so bad, it really shouldn't be on the project, that just honestly wasn't any good at all. There's none of that. Like, this project just completely rides all the way through, and the fact that it is a completely themed project, each song has its own individual meaning, so it all is a solid joint. It's just nothing about it is phenomenal at the same time. Like, even though you're going to listen to every single song here, honestly, it's going to become background music eventually, because nothing about it is that great. Taking songs like Morning Shift, where what he's talking about on this one is, you know, how there's no support here in Charlotte. There's nobody helping each other. Honestly, people will sabotage you at all points in time, man. And he goes in and starts talking individual things, like how he hasn't released a project in 5 years. And that's honestly why I may not have actually heard of him. Because I've been reviewing music now for, what, 6 years and such? And my first year that I jumped into it, I may have just plain missed him because I wasn't heavy into the underground up until, like, 2 years or 3 years into this thing, man. So that's honestly why I've never heard of him. The next song is That Still Slumming, in which this was a rather deep one, where this is him getting recognized by his people in the hood, and they saying, why are you back in the hood? Like, you was out there with J. Cole. You need to be out there doing more work with him. You need to continue to strive to come up. As he's talking to one of his individual homies, and how his homie is telling him how he influenced him, and that's just some real talk, because when you come up out of nothing, because ain't nobody in Charlotte actually really make it out here into the game, you dig? Like, there has been a certain select of individuals that have made a buzz and has actually done some things, like Betty Grind or Mr. 704, like all of these names. People may have heard a song from them, man, but they never really did it on a level in which people really want individuals from Charlotte to do it. And his individual homie is looking at him like, man, why is you back in the hood? Nothing good happens here and all of that, man. And you're influencing us to go out there and do bigger things for ourselves, man. You need to go out there, keep on grinding. The next song I want to talk about is that Ambition, where on this one, he's talking about how he wants more than just working a job and being out there hustling or anything like that. He actually wants to go out there and provide more things for his family, but yet he does it with some interesting bars all throughout. How he said in Charlotte, man, it's either you balling or you going out to get a job. And when it comes to balling, his shot is off, just like it was for Cheddar Bob, in which that was pretty cool, because if you guys remember Cheddar Bob, the character from 8 Mile who shot himself, he's referencing that, pretty much just saying he ain't got a jump shot, so he has to go out here and hustle hard to go ahead and get his solid balls right there. How he said that he's far from a trap rapper, but yet he stays strapped like a Eastpak backpacker. Like, that was pretty cool, because Eastpak is an actual backpack that backpackers, which is like a type of individual who always keep a backpack on them wherever they go and all that. That's like a style for them. Like, he's honestly referencing it all together. Solid stuff. The next song that I want to talk about is that Get Up, where this is him talking about how he got laid off of his job and all of that, and now he need to go out there and get it. Like, he ain't got nothing else to do but get out here and get his hustle on. And this is something that a lot of people always tend to say. Like, whenever a guy has a child, they say, I got no choice but to go out here and get it now. Or whenever they go ahead and get fired from a job, they got to go out here and get it. But most people never get it, you dig? Like, either you got the hustle or you don't. And even if you got like the job and all of that, man, you need to be hustling to go along with it already, you dig? If you're not hustling with that job, then you're not going to hustle without it, you feel me? But honestly, he overtly shows that he got the hustle in order to get to where he's at right now, and which I salute the man for. And I could go on and on, man, because all of the songs are of the same standard quality, you did, but yet I ain't got the time for that. And the last song I honestly need to go ahead and touch on is that Juggin' Joint, where this is him talking about how he's out here hustling, trying to come up. But there was one bar in particular that I rather enjoyed, when he said that he feels like Will Smith in that 7 Pounds, how he'll give up and sacrifice everything about himself so other people can smile. That was deep, because for those of you who didn't see the movie 7 Pounds, not trying to spoil it for you, but you should have seen it by now if you were ever going to see it. But this is him, Will Smith, pretty much killing himself and donating all of his organs to individual people and all of that, man. And that's him sacrificing himself so other people can go ahead and live a life. I like how he applied that to his own struggle and all that, man. Solid bars. Honestly, it's a solid project all the way through, man. I'ma give this joint a 6.5 out of 10. But yet my thing is, it just wasn't strong. Like, nothing about it really stood out amongst everything else in the music industry. And you know, this is something that J. Cole constantly seeks out, this same exact sound all the time and such, man. So he honestly just blends in with what the rest of Dreamsville does. And I'm not so sure if that's like the best case for this individual artist, but hopefully with the right promotion, he can go ahead and shine out here. I'm rooting for him, for him being from Charlotte and all that, man. Not very many people actually come up out of Charlotte and actually do things on the level in which he's at right now. I hope you enjoyed the show. You can follow me at Twitter up there, and you can go to downloadpaz.com, that's down there, to read today's article.